So we learned about the Kronecker delta, the Levi-Civita symbol, and the Einstein summation convention. The purpose is to prove some vector identities. These vector identities are useful when you manipulate equations such as occurs in fluid mechanics or in electricity and magnetism. So I'm going to talk about four vector identities. In the lectures, I'll prove two of them and then ask you to do two of them as problems. So let's go through them. There's two types of vector identities. There's scalar vector identities, where the left-hand side is a scalar and the right-hand side is a scalar. And there are vector identities, where the left-hand side's a vector and the right-hand side's a vector. So when two vectors are equal, it means that all of their components are equal. So that's essentially three equations, but we can solve them as a single equation. So let's go through them. The scalar triple product, then, is a scalar vector identity. It says that A dot B cross C, so B cross C is a vector, and A is a vector, so A dot B cross C is a scalar. That's equal to B dot C cross A is equal to C dot A cross B. So the equality is basically a cyclical rotation of A, B, C. So A, B, C, B, C, A, C, A, B. Okay? The vector triple product is also having to do with three vectors, but this is a vector identity. Here, A cross B cross C, so B cross C is a vector, and A cross a vector is a vector. It says that A cross B cross C is equal to A dot C, a scalar, times B, a vector, minus A dot B, a scalar, times C, a vector. Okay? That's the vector triple product. The third identity is the scalar quadruple product. That's a scalar vector identity. Quadruple means that there are four vectors involved. Here, A cross B dot C cross D. So it's a vector dot a vector, which is a scalar. That's equal to A dot C, which is a scalar, times B dot D, which is also a scalar, minus A dot D times B dot C. So A dot C, B dot D, minus AD, A dot D, B dot C, okay? So all these have some type of symmetry if you look at them carefully. The fourth one on this list, there are also other ones, but I'm going to just discuss these four. The vector quadruple product is a vector identity. Quadruple, so it has four vectors. It's A cross B cross C cross D, so that's a vector cross a vector is a vector. That's equal to A cross B dot D, that's a scalar, times C, a vector, minus A cross B dot C, a scalar, times D, a vector. Okay, how do we prove these identities? We need a toolbox, which we already developed. So let's go through what we will need in our toolbox. If we look at the Levi-Civita symbol, epsilon I j k, we're allowed to cyclically permute these indices. So this is equal to epsilon j k I and is equal to epsilon Kij, okay? So that's kind of an operation we're allowed with this Levi-Civita symbol. That's one of the elements of our toolbox. The next element will be what happens if we contract one of these indices. So epsilon ijk times epsilon imn, right? So we're working under the Einstein summation convention. So that means where I is repeated, So that means we say that I is contracted if an index repeats. That means we're summing over I. So we're summing over I equals 1, 2, 3. So there are three terms here, right? That's the summation. This reduces to products of Kronecker deltas. So as a problem, you're supposed to prove this. This is equal to delta Jm delta Kn, right, minus delta Jn delta Km. Okay? This is a very important identity that we'll use in the proof of these vector identities. So how do you remember this? So we're only contracting the first index. Usually, I like to always put the contracting index in the first slot. I can do that by using this cyclical identity for the indices. So we contract the first index, and then we have delta Jm Kn. So you see second index, third index, and then minus Jn Km. So third index, second index. Okay, so that's how you can remember that identity. Okay, another identity is delta Ij A sub j under the Einstein summation convention. So this is a sum from j equals 1 to 3. The Kronecker delta then is 0 unless j is equal to I. So that picks out A sub I. If you wrote out all three terms, you would see that this is the identity. It actually doesn't matter whether J is the second index on the Kronecker delta, or this was delta Ji, since delta Ij equals delta Ji. But it looks prettier if we contract the second index, that's all. Finally, what I've talked about already, we can write A dot B using the Einstein summation convention is just AI BI, right? So sum over I, so A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3. So the dot product can be written in terms of these index symbols. And the other product is the cross product, so A cross B. But you have to say what component you're looking at. So I use this bracket symbol and put a subscript I here. So that means we're looking at the ith component of A cross B. This can be written very nicely in terms of the Levi-Civita symbol. This is epsilon. The ith component you put in the first index of the symbol, and then two other indices, here I call them JK, they're going to be summed over. The second index will correspond to A, so this will be AJ, and the third index will correspond to B, and that will be BK, okay? So this cross product can be written in terms of A cross B, the ith component, is epsilon IJK AJBK under the Einstein summation convention. So you can show that as a problem, okay? And that's all the tools we need. So let me summarize. These are four sometimes useful identities when you're dealing with the vectors of electricity and magnetism, the electric field, the magnetic field, or the equations of fluid mechanics, where the velocity field then is a vector. And then I want to at least show you how such identities can be proved using the Kronecker delta, the Levi-Civita symbol, and our Einstein summation convention. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.